ഞാൻ ചെയ്യും. ഹരി ഓം. നമ്മുടെ നെക്സ്റ്റ് ചോദ്യം എന്താണ്? ഇന്ത്യയിലെ ഹരിത വിപ്ലവത്തിന്റെ പിതാവ് ആരാണ്? ഉത്തരം ഡോക്ടർ എം എസ് സ്വാമിനാഥൻ.
Provides you with a lot of accurate information, and therefore it enables what we call precision breeding. You can take what you want exactly and so on. But almost all, 99% of the varieties in the field are all what you may call conventional breeding or Mendelian breeding, coming from normal genetics. And even if we have through genomics one particular gene transferred, the other characters, agronomic characters and so on, will be needed. So it will always be an integrated breeding. Occasionally, like a mutation, if you have one particular change, you may have genomics alone. But as I see it, it will be both the Mendelian and molecular breeding go together in an appropriate way. And so it is one more tool. In the evolution of tools for transferring genes, genomics is a very important issue.
That the wheat cultivation in India started in the Mohenjo-Daro time. That's the earliest record, the Mohenjo-Daro excavations. 4,000 years, when we became independent, the production of wheat was 6 million tons. In other words, in 4 years, our farmers, particularly, I'm happy to see the Ministry for Food Processing, farmers of Punjab, Haryana, many others, our farmers achieved, produced more food, more wheat than the previous 4,000 years. That is why it's called a revolution. Otherwise, it's an evolutionary change, but it's a revolution. I'm so happy to see the Minister for Agriculture and Farmers' Welfare. I think the farmers' welfare is very important. And I'm sure the achievement of the what I said from the days of Mohenjo-Daro to the days of 1947, the achievement of the farmers was enormous. There was not very much of a scientific support at that time. That the days of those covered in this book, 50 years of Green Revolution. I can't think in those days what was happening. The whole world was full of doomsday experts. In fact, we had one old day.
In 1982, Dr. Swaminathan went to the International Rice Research Institute, IRRI, in Manila, Philippines, as its Director General.